Ikhwani, when you want to sin and when you want to do something wrong, Ikhwani, remember the one that owns everything can see you. فَلَا تَجْعَلْ don't make Allah أَقْبَحُ النَّاظِرِينَ إِلَيْكَ. When you lie, when you trick, when you fool, when you speak wrong, when you act against your religion, don't make Allah the one that watches and looks at the worst of things. You respect others and you wouldn't want them to see it, but when it comes to Allah, you do. And who's better than Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an? Abu Bakr used to say to the people, استحيوا من الله, be shy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنِّي وَاللَّهِ أَسْتَحْيِي مِنَ اللَّهِ, I feel shy of Allah, that when I go to do my call of nature, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, when I go to do my call of nature, wallahi, I veil my face, I put niqab on, حَيَاءً مِنَ اللَّهِ, because I'm very shy of him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, the great companion he was, he said, wallahi, مَا اغْتَسَلْتُ قَائِمًا, I never had a bath standing up, ever. I mean, I never straightened my back. بمعنى ما استقمت ظهري, I never straightened my back. Why? Abu Musa al-Ash'ari was said, he always used to have a bath sitting down, and he would have it in a dark place. Why? حَيَاءً مِنَ اللَّهِ, because he was shy of Allah. He didn't want Allah to see his aura. He didn't want to show Allah this. حَيَاء. إخواني, the shyness of theirs reached an extent that the companions, they came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one time, and they asked him, Ya Rasulallah, advise me, a man said. He said, oh, sin, Ya Rasulallah, give me an advice. You know what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him? He said, استحيوا من الله, be shy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, كما تستحي من رجل صالح من بني قومك. Be shy of Allah the way you would be shy of Allah, a righteous man of your best of the people that you're from. If you see a person in your righteous people that you're from, you will never dare to do that in front of him. Be shy of Allah as much as you see that. No one would ever dare think of the best person as the most noblest in your eyes and try to picture yourself in front of that person. How would you deal with it? You'll never dare to do that. Then remember, don't make Allah the one that you belittle more than that person. The reality, and this is the harsh reality that Ummah today we live in. And all of this comes back to lack of understanding of what these ayat and these verses mean. Ikhwani, the Sahabas were not metals and robots. The Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum ajma'in wa Ummah, every verse they looked at it and they sat down, and they made it enter their body and their minds and their hearts, and they digested it as it was. They lived by it day, they lived by it in morning, they lived by afternoon, and at night before they slept, they lived by this. It was a principle that was qa'im, forever to be. And you as a person have to be like that.